Hi, I'm Niki. Welcome to my lab. Today I'm going to try to repair this Fluke 17B multimeter. Together with 15B model, they have been producing in China, and as far as I know, there are only two multimeters which are made in China. The problem in this multimeter is that it doesn't turn on. So I'm going to put in on my bench and see what's inside of it. Here is the unit, and this is the schematics of this meter. As you can see, the entire unit has been designed on over a single chip solution here. This is the typical Fluke input circuit and the cold compensation network. Here is the precision resistor network divider. I did some tests already, and I found that there is no any oscillation here across the crystal oscillator. Also, there are two voltages, analog voltage outputs. Probably there are internal DC to DC converters, maybe, but also there seems to be that. This indicates that probably, or I think that the entire chip is broken, and I need to find a new one and try to find a way to replace it, because as you can see, it's chip on board. After a month of waiting, the new chip arrived. I'm going to try to remove the epoxy resin using a hot iron, but if it's not possible, I think to try with the Dremel. I think all the pins are okay. There is no short between them, and all of them seems to be good soldered on the PCB. This unit works with two AA batteries, so I'm curious to see, does it work? Yes. Oh, great! It works. Great. Oops. Yeah. Now it's time to take the PCB off again and to put it into the ultrasonic cleaner, because I touch it and it needs to be clean. Also, I'm going to clean the plastics, and I'm going to show you how to clean the top cover, this plastic window, on the multimeter. To clean the top window of the display, I need to put some paper scotch to protect the plastic around the display, like so. And I'm going to use two different sandpapers. I'm going to use 1050 and 2000, and two polisher. This is from 3M. This is raw, and this is fine polish paste. Now I'm going to wash the plastics to clean the PCB into the ultrasonic cleaner, and then it's time for calibration. The board and the plastics are clean now. Just to note that if you want to clean PCBs into ultrasonic cleaner with a specific cleaning solution, I use this Aquanox concentrate for cleaning boards. Don't forget to put a tape over these labels, because the chemical is strong enough to remove the numbers or letters here. And also the solder speakers like this, because you can damage them inside the ultrasonic cleaner. So I have to solder this piezo back into the board and put everything into the unit. I did the calibration of the camera because the video would take a long time. There is a calibration menu, and I simply followed the steps there, trimming the internal trim pots using this Fluke as a reference. I hope you enjoyed this unusual chip-on-board repair. I haven't done this before, but I'm happy that the repair was successful. If so, please give me a thumbs up and like my channel. See you soon!